وبارك وسلم. روى الإمام مالك عن أبي الزناد عن الأعرج عن أبي هريرة رضي الله أنه قال: قال مولانا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: إذا أنت لصاحبك أمسك، والإمام يخطب يوم الجمعة فقد لغاه. وفي حديث آخر: ومن لغى فلا جمعة له. أنصتوا رحمكم الله، أنصتوا وفقكم الله، أنصتوا يغفر لي ولكم الله. الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة.
بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: إن الذين يبايعون allegiance to you, pledge their allegiance to Allah. Allah's hand is over their hands. And he who breaks his pledge only breaks it against himself. But as for him who fulfills the contract he has made with Allah, we will pay him an immense reward. فَسَأْتُكِيهِ أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. This oath mentioned in this ayah refers to بَيَعَةُ الْرِضْوَانِ, and is mentioned in Surat al-Fatiha. Surat al-Fath. Those who gave the oath of loyalty, the bay'ah, to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Hudaybiyah, gave an oath to the Messenger of Allah and gave an oath to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqul, man yuti'i rasula faqad ta'a Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, whoever obeys the Messenger has obeyed Allah. In the hadith of Abu Hurayra, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is a hadith contained in the two sahihs in Bukhari and Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam connects obedience to the Amir to obedience to Rasul, to obedience to Allah. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man ata'ani faqad ata'a Allah, wa man asani faqad asa Allah, wa man yuti'i al-Amir faqad ata'ani, وَمَنْ يُعْسِ الْأَمِيرِ فَقَدْ عَسَانِ. Whoever obeys me, he says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whoever obeys me has obeyed Allah. And whoever rebels against me or disobeys me has rebelled against Allah. And whoever obeys the Amir has obeyed me, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And whoever disobeys the Amir disobeys me. The bay'ah is a sunnah, and it is a forgotten sunnah. The ceremony and the formality of keeping the oath of loyalty to an Amir has a great blessing, because it is an act of gravity, of manliness, of sincerity, and because it is following the practice of the Sahaba with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Salaf Salih, the righteous generations of our Ummah. However, the most important aspect is not the formality or the ceremony, but rather the actual commitment, the fulfillment of the oath, of loyalty and obedience. This is the antidote against the poison of the individualistic way of life of our time. The hand of Allah, he says in the ayah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the hand of Allah is over their hands. يَدُ اللَّهِ فَوْقَ أَيْدِيهِمْ. So when they gave the bay'ah to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah says, the hand of Allah is above their hands. Imam al-Qurtubi, explaining this expression, says, they promised loyalty to Allah, and Allah promised them above them recompense. They offered obedience to Allah, and Allah gave them above them guidance. And Ibn Kisan added, the hand of Allah is above their hands, means the strength of Allah and His help is with them above their own strength and their own resources. No one should look at these ayats about the bay'ah to Ridwan, or to any other ayats in the Quran for that matter, as a narrative of glorious events in the age of the prophecy, but rather as Allah addressing Himself directly to us in our situation. Each one of them is significant, every one of the ayats of the Book of Allah is significant and incumbent upon us. The ayats of the Quran are signs. They show us the way to sanity, to truthfulness. They indicate the path to attain the pleasure of our Lord. Allah commands the believers to obey Him, and to obey His Messenger, and to obey the people of authority among us. It is an obligation on the Muslims to live in Jama'ah. This obligation is implicit in the command of Allah, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ amri minkum. This is referring to us. He says, the translation of which is, you who have iman, obey Allah and obey the Messenger and those who have authority among you. The commands and the prohibitions of the Quran are relevant upon mankind. They are the path of success until the end of time. And the sunnah of his messenger, Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barika alayhi, is the correct guidance, the ship of salvation in the tempests of each epoch and age. The command to be united as one community is also implied in the ayah that we repeat so many times, and every Friday you hear it from the minbar. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. The translation of which is, hold fast together to the rope of Allah and do not separate. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاعْتِيُوا اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا فَتَفْشَلُوا وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ وَاصْبِرُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. The translation of which is, and obey Allah and His Messenger, and do not dispute with one another. Do not quarrel between yourselves, or else you will be demoralized. You will falter, and your strength will depart from you. And persevere. Wasbiru inna Allaha ma'a as-sabirin. Persevere, be patient, because Allah is with the patient ones. Do not quarrel between yourselves, so that you will be divided. As a result, you will split, there will be distance between you, and your hearts will separate. Your strength, rihukum, in the Quranic expression, is the same word as wind. And the Mufassirun explain it as a ship in the sea. When the wind is favorable, the boat advances. Your strength, rihukum, the wind that blows in your favor, favorable wind, that makes you advance in the right direction, and that blows in the face of your enemies. You will lose your strength if you quarrel between you. You will lose your impulse. Success will escape from your hands. Commenting on this ayah, Mujahid ibn Jabir, one of the tabi'een and one of the most reliable commentators of the Quran, Mujahid, said, in the day of Uhud, the favorable wind abandoned the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because they quarreled. They disobeyed the command of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they disobeyed their Amir, who was appointed over them on the hill. Ja'a Abdullah ibn Umar ila Abdullah ibn Muti'a hina kana min amri al-harra ma kana. Zaman Yazid ibn Muawiyah. Faqal atrihu li Abi Abd al-Rahman wa huwa Abdullah ibn Umar. أطلحوا لأبي عبد الرحمن وسادة فقال رضي الله عنه إني لم أتيك لأجلس أتيتك لأحدثك حديثا سمعته من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من خلع يادا من دعا لقي الله يوم القيامة لا حجة له ومن مات وليس في عنقه بيعة Abdullah ibn Umar, may Allah be pleased with him and with his father, Umar ibn al-Khattab, said, I heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, whoever withdraws his hand from obedience will meet Allah on the Yawm al-Qiyamah and will have no argument in his defense. And whoever dies and does not have a commitment of loyalty, of ba'idah, and in Israel he says hanging on his neck, an oath of loyalty to his Amir, he will die the death of Jahiliyyah. This is a sound, authentic, undisputed hadith. The obligation of giving allegiance to an imam, to the leader of the Muslim community, is a sunnah. Being involved in in the affairs of the local Muslim community is a prerequisite to be involved and concerned with the affairs of the Ummah. Living and dying the death of Jahiliyyah is something that can be seen. It doesn't need much explanation. Bay'ah is a sunnah, and it is a forgotten sunnah. The argument that Bay'ah is not incumbent since the time of Khulafa al-Rashidun, or that it's not obligatory to have a Muslim leader to give allegiance, our allegiance is only due to Imam al-Uthma, that is the Khalif of all the Muslims, is a false argument. It was already dismissed many centuries ago when there was an Umayyad Khalif in Cordoba and there was an Abbasid Khalif in Baghdad. The people of knowledge unanimously agreed that the oath of allegiance to the leader of the Muslims was obligatory on every Muslim to whoever Allah had given authority in every place and time. The community of the believers, above whom the hand of Allah is a sound social body, cemented by the qualities of true brotherhood, the marks of preference, mutual support, mutual advice, and loyalty to an emir. This is the only possible way of life of the Muslims. Strength is in the Jama'ah, and Allah loves those who love each other for his sake. The Amir does not need to be a scholar. He can have scholars to be his advisors. The Amir does not need to be Superman. His success is based on the good and sincere advice and the support of the men and women of his community. Allah helped his messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with his own help and with the help of the believers. It would have been sufficient for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to say, we helped you with our support. But he said, huwa alladhi ayyadaka binasrihi wa bil mu'minin. The translation of which is, it is he who supported you with his help and with the mu'minun. They are the people of authority, they are the people of ma'rifah, and they are the people of ilm. And then there is the authority of the Muslim leader of the community. In the early generations of Islam, these aspects of authority were all one and the same, embodied in one person. In our time, the recovery of sovereignty of our communities and our ummah will come from righteous leaders and actively committed scholars, united with mutual recognition, with mutual courtesy, respect, each one giving the other his due. What seems now normal is not necessarily what is correct. There are many things that are not right, and we know it with knowledge of certainty that they are not correct. We know it in our heart, and we know it because we have the confirmation of the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That certainty cannot be debilitated by any form of dominant opinion, political ideology, or even legal enforcement. Holding to our certainty is the internal strength of the believer. Holding fast together to the Jama'ah is the collective strength of the community, of the Muslim community. And all strength is from Allah. All power belongs to Him. By being slaves to Him, by obeying Him, and by being thankful to Him, we assure our success in this life and the next. What has happened to the Muslims that we are not strongly organized communities with clear leadership? Do we not know that whenever three people went on a journey or an expedition, the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, appointed one of them as the Amir? Do we not remember that the Prophet of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, you should listen and obey to your leader, even Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu ati'ullaha wa ati'ur rasul wa ulil amri minkum. The translation of which is, you who have iman, obey Allah and obey the messenger, and those in command, those who have authority among you, this is from Allah addressed to us. Since the abolition of the Ottoman Caliphate and the last Mughal Dawla in the Indian subcontinent, the traditional Muslim lands have adopted the political model of the nation state. In that model, Islam has been relegated to private practices of worship, the ibadat, and personal morals. The only exception being Morocco, where the leader of the nation is the Amir al-Mu'minin. Instead of having civic leaders, the Muslim countries have accepted the new status quo and surrendered all their civic affairs to the political class, while resorting to a sort of clergy that leads the prayers, conducts janazas, sees to the weddings, and teaches Islamic sciences, but turning a blind eye to a whole dimension of our human existence, and therefore a whole dimension of the deen of Allah, the mu'amalat. The mu'amalat refer to the integrity in the marketplace, avoidance of usury, stopping corruption, fighting injustice, the collection and the distribution of zakat, and establishing the deen in its full extent. In his book, in his brief but very precious and valuable book, as a manual to Muslim leaders, written by the founder of this mosque, Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Sufi, the book entitled The Muslim Dreams, he says, zakat is the foundation stone of the state without usury. And he also says, zakat is the seal of the abolition of the mushrik system called capitalism. The prevailing formula in the Muslim countries is devised to perpetuate individualism, that is, to relegate the affairs, the ibadat, and the social morals and personal morals to a clergy, is a formula that perpetuates individualism and prevents the power of the Muslim community, the Jama'ah, and curtails the scope of the deen of Islam. This formulation that attempts to restrict the relevance and the validity of Islam and to reduce it to a religion in the Christian sense of the word religion, which is not the meaning of deen. A strong Muslim Jama'ah is not passive in the face of injustices and oppression. The Muslims are not tamed. We are not tamed because we do not fear anyone other than Allah. Our struggle, our jihad in this age, as in every age, is to strive together and united to create and to defend and to protect a safe space where Allah can be worshipped, in which bir and ihsan can be practiced, to clean ourselves and our communities in as much as we are able from the filth of the haram that surrounds us, a space to raise our children in fitrah, and to which we can invite others to live in the safety of Islam. The ayah, so many times repeated, and hold fast together to the robe of Allah and do not separate, and the hadith of Abdullah ibn Umar, whoever dies and does not have the commitment of ba'yah, the loyalty to an amir, he will die the death of jahiliyyah, are enough proof to provide clarity on this matter. The fact that Muslims are not permitted to remain leaderless. Giving allegiance to an amir is a necessary part of the life of a Muslim, and the fact that this has become strange, has become rare and unusual in our time, does not mean that it's not true and does not invalidate this important aspect of our deen. Many things are prevailing in our time that are incorrect, unjust, corrupt, contrary to the deen of Allah, and we know with knowledge of certainty that they are the cause of the anger of Allah. Our certainty is over and above the prevailing tides of opinion, the dominant ideologies, and the discourses of the kuffar. Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqan, wa'asukna al-tibaha, wa'arina al-batila batila, wa'asukna ijtinaba. Allah, make us see the truest truth, and grant us that we follow it. Allah, make us see false as falseness, and grant us that we avoid it. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين وتابع التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. فيا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ما استطعتم واسمعوا وأطيعوا وأنفقوا خيرا لأنفسكم ومن يوق شح نفسه فأولئك هم المفلحون. عباد الله، أوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله وطاعته وأحذركم وإياي عن معصيتي ومخالفاتي. أما بعد، إن الله تبارك وتعالى يقول: إن الله يحب الذين يقاتلون في سبيله صفا كأنهم بنيان مرصوص. الله تبارك وتعالى says in his book, the translation of which is: Allah loves those who strive in his way in compact ranks like a well-built wall. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: كونوا عباد الله إخوانا لا تعادوا ولا تباغضوا سددوا وقاربوا وابشروا. The Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said: Be servants of Allah, be slaves of Allah, and be brothers. Do not be hostile to one another. Do not hate one another. Follow the right course. Sadbilu is the same word that is brought in the ayah. Qaul wa qulu qawlan sadida. Say the truth. Be truthful. Follow the right course. Be correct. Seek nearness to Allah. Wa qaribu. And give good tidings. Give glad tidings. Give good news. وأبشروا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says: وتعاونوا على البر والتقوى ولا تعاونوا على الإثم والعدوان واتقوا الله إن الله شديد العقاب. The translation of which is: cooperate in virtue and right action and taqwa, and do not cooperate in evil and oppression. Abu Hurairah, may Allah be pleased with him, narrated that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said: Verily, Allah is pleased with you for three things, and He is angry with you for three things. He is pleased with you that you worship Allah alone and do not associate anything with Him, that you hold all together to the rope of Allah and you do not separate, and that you give good advice to those who Allah has given authority over you in your affairs. And He is angry with you for three things. Qila wa qal, gossip, talking nonsense and passing on gossip and talking about people in their backs. Asking too many questions, which is a superficiality of the intellect, and lack of reflection, lack of depth, and lack of listening, and squandering wealth. He is angry with you for three things. Gossip, asking too many questions, and squandering wealth. Allahumma, give strength and cohesion to the Ummah of Islam. And give strength and unity to our community. Allahumma, give us certainty, a certainty that fortifies us to take upon ourselves our own share of responsibility, each one of us, man and woman. Ya Allah, give us leaders with taqwa of you. act according to that knowledge. Amen. Allah bless the founder of this mosque. Amen. And his community, Sheikh Abu Qadir al-Sufi, multiply his reward. Amen. And give us your support and the support of the believers. Give our support and the support of the believers to the Amir of this community, and give him the strength to carry out his duty, and inspire us loyalty to assist him and to share that weighty responsibility. وَيَا رَبِّ افْتَحْ فَتْحَكَ الْمُبِينَ لِمَنْ تَوَلَّ وَأَعَزَّ الدِّينَ وَانْصُرْ يَا طَوْلِ وَانْصُرْ حِزْبَهُ وَامْلَأَ بِمَا يُرْضِيكَ عَنْهُ قَلْبَهُ يَا رَبِّ وَانْصُرْ دِينَكَ الْمُحَمَّدِي وَاجْعَلْ خِتَامَهُ وَاجْعَلْ خِتَامَ عِزِّهِ كَمَا بُدِينَ. I want to make an announcement. There will be gathering here at the mosque every night for the next 3 nights. Today, Friday, tomorrow, Saturday, and the next day, Sunday, after Maghrib prayer. To celebrate the Muslim of Cape Town, which is an event of Quran, Dhikr, Hadra, discourses of knowledge and advice, and coincides with the birthday of the founder of this mosque, Sheikh Abu Qadir al-Sufi. May Allah be well pleased with him and have mercy on him, who passed away on the 1st of August last year. This is an international gathering of people from all over the world who have come. Many of them are already here. The event is open to all Muslims, male and female, above 15 years of age. So we invite you and your families and friends to join us for one of the nights or for the 3 nights. Ananas, qala Rasulullah, Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, akthiru as-salata alayya yawm al-jumu'ah wal-layla wa laylat al-jumu'ah faman salla alayya sallallahu alayhi sallam wa man salla alayya salatan sallallahu alayhi ashra. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala an-nabi ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik alayhi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين ابي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن عائشه رضي الله عنها وسائر ازواج النبي وعن سائر الصحابه اجمعين خصوصا منهم الانصار والمهاجرين وعن التابعين وتابع التابعين ومن تبعهم باحسان الى يوم الدين وجعل منهم ومعهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم بارك على اميرنا وعلى جميع الامراء وسعداء المسلمين. اللهم اهدي ولاة امور المسلمين لما يرضيك ولاتباع سنه نبيك صلى الله عليه وسلم وثبت قدمنا على صراط المستقيم واصلحهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارحم شيخ عبد القادر مؤسس هذا المسجد وجزيه عنا خير الجزاء. اللهم بارك على المسلمين في هذه المدينه ووفقهم ما تحبه وترضاه يا اكرم الاكرمين. اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين. اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين. اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين واخذل الكفر والكافرين وانصر المجاهدين في سبيل الله واجعل كلماتك هي العليا وكلمات الكفر هي السفلى. ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم.